A Spikelet of Wheat, a Ukrainian folktale. Once upon a time, there lived a cockerel and two little mice named Twist and Spin. All day long, the little mice were singing and dancing, twisting and spinning, which is probably why their names were Twist and Spin. The cockerel usually woke up at sunrise. His main duty was to sing a loud song to wake everyone up, and then he would begin to work. One day, the cockerel was sweeping the courtyard and suddenly noticed a spikelet of wheat that was lying on the ground. The cockerel rejoiced and called the mice, "Hey Spin! Hey Twist! Hurry, look what I found!" The little mice came very fast and said,
"Wow! A spikelet of wheat! It should surely be threshed!"
"All right, and who is going to thresh it?" asked the cockerel.
"Not me!"
screamed one.
"Me neither!"
screamed another. "Well," said the cockerel, "I suppose I will thresh the spikelet of wheat." As he began to thresh, the little mice started to play the game tag. When the cockerel had finished threshing, he called the little mice again. "Hey Twist, hey Spin, look at how many grains I've threshed." The little mice didn't even want to stop their games, as it wasn't important to them at that very moment. They replied to him from afar,
"Good job, cockerel! Now the grain should be carried to the mill to be ground into flour."
"Okay, who will carry it?" asked the cockerel.
"Oh, not me,"
shouted Twist.
"Me neither,"
shouted Spin. "Well," thought the cockerel, "that's the way it goes. I guess I will have to carry it." The cockerel slung the sackful of grains over his shoulder and went to the mill. The little mice just continued having fun and playing different games. Meanwhile, the cockerel threshed the grains and came back home. He called the mice again. "Twist! Spin! I brought the flour." The little mice came to the cockerel and, seeing the flour, began to praise him.
"Well done! Good for you! Perfect job! Now the dough must be kneaded and then baked into cakes."
"And who is going to knead?" asked the cockerel.
"Oh, not me! Not me!"
screamed the little mice together, and immediately they ran off to play hide-and-seek. The cockerel sighed and said, "Then it seems that I will have to knead the dough." He kneaded the dough, chopped some wood, stoked the stove, and molded the cakes. As soon as the stove was stoked, he put the cakes inside to bake. The little mice were also not bored. They sang songs, danced, and laughed loudly. Soon, the cakes were ready in the stove, and a very pleasant smell spread around the house. As soon as the cakes had been baked, the cockerel took them out, put them on a dish, and placed the dish on the table. When the mice smelled this tasty smell, they appeared right next to the table. The cockerel did not even have to call them this time.
"I'm so hungry,"
squeaked Twist.
"I want to eat too,"
squeaked Spin. They sat down at the table immediately and reached their little paws to the cakes when suddenly the cockerel said to them,
Wait.
First tell me, who found the spikelet of wheat?"
"You found it,"
the little mice shouted.
"Well, then who threshed it?" asked the cockerel again.
"You threshed it,"
the mice answered a little quieter. "Who brought the grain to the mill?"
"It was also you,"
Twist and Spin answered very quietly.
"And who kneaded the dough, chopped the wood, and stoked the stove? Who molded the cakes?"
"You did it. You did everything,"
the little mice squeaked.
"And please, tell me, what did you do all this time?"
What could they answer? There was nothing to say. So Twist and Spin quietly left their seats at the table and went outside. The cockerel did not try to stop them. After all, who wants to treat such lazy bones and idlers with delicious cakes?